What an amazing top five. Each contestant is incredible. But that being said, any surprises there for you, Olivia?
Yes, I liked Miss Iceland a lot. And yeah. I loved her dress. But whatever. I mean, you know, you never know with these things. That's the hard part.
Absolutely. And coming up, the final question round. How do you prepare for that?
Honestly, it's just a lot of preparing. If you fail to prepare, then you prepare to fail. I had no cards. I had random people ask me questions because it really is mostly the nerves, because you can get up there on stage and then just completely freeze, even though you've studied the topic. Yeah. So you just have to practice under pressure. I think that's the key. I mean, because you never know. This might be uninteresting.
Practice under pressure. Speak from the heart. Be yourself. The nerves back here. Back to you, Steve.
Well, as we all know, Miss Universe is not just a title. The woman who wins that crown instantly becomes a global ambassador. She must be a great communicator, quick and clear and confident. This question round puts that ability to the test. Once I read the question, you will have 30 seconds to answer. When your time is up, you will hear this sound. Here we go. Mexico, you're first. Please join me, center stage. Here's your question. Recently, many countries have seen protests in their streets. Some have led to violence. Is protest a positive way to create change?
I believe in the cause. I believe in creating change. And I do believe in raising our voices. We need to be heard. And some of these protests are really powerful and they can create a positive impact. But I do not believe in violence, because violence is always going to create violence. I really believe that what we should do is come together, raise our voices, and make an impact in the best possible way ever. Through these kind of platforms like Miss Universe, through kind of platforms like TED Talks. That's why I'm here, and I really believe that that's what you should do. Thank you.
Thank you, Mexico. Thailand, you're next. Here's your question. Government surveillance is used to keep many nations and their people safe, but some believe this invades our right to privacy. What is more important to you, privacy or security?
That's a very tough question. I believe that every country has their own government policy to keep us safe, and I believe that it shouldn't cross the line of going into our privacy, because we have a right to privacy. But security is also very important, so I believe that in order to live in a better society, we should also have the government look into a line, a middle ground, as to where they can come and live together with society.
Good. Thank you, Thailand. Colombia, come on over. Okay, here's your question. Millions of women worldwide lack access to reproductive health care. What do you believe is the most important issue in women's health and why?
Millones de mujeres no tienen acceso, por todo el mundo, no tienen acceso al salud reproductivo. ¿Qué crees es el más importante tema en la salud de las mujeres y por qué?
Yo creo que lo más importante es que las mujeres podamos decidir sobre nuestros propios cuerpos.
I think the most important thing is that women are able to choose about their own body.
Tenemos que tener la posibilidad de acceder a salud de calidad.
We have to have the option to have quality care.
Para que cualquier decisión que tomemos sobre nuestro cuerpo, sobre nuestra salud y sobre nuestra reproducción.
So any decision we make about our body, about our health, about our reproduction.
Jamás ponga en riesgo nuestras vidas.
Will ever put us in risk, especially our lives.
Thank you, Colombia. It's time, Puerto Rico. Here's your question. Social media, Social media has empowered people to express their beliefs, but sometimes those beliefs are intolerant and dangerous. Should social media platforms respect free speech or regulate what people post?
I most definitely believe that social media can be a positive aspect in our lives. We can share information, knowledge. However, it can be used in the wrong hands and spew negativity and harm many people. So I believe that social media should identify the people who are spewing such negativity and hurting self-esteem on other people to make sure that they're not abusing the system such as social media. Thank you.
Thank you, Puerto Rico. South Africa, this last one is for you. Here's your question. Are leaders of today doing enough to protect future generations from climate change? If not, what more should they be doing?
Steve, I think that the future leaders could do a little bit more. But however, I feel like we as individuals ourselves can also play a part in making the climate the way it should be in the future. I mean, we have children protesting for climate, and I feel like as adults we should join as well. We should have corporations join as well, and the government should take it seriously. I mean, from sixth grade, I've been learning that the climate is deteriorating and the planet is dying, and it is up to us to keep our planet safe. Thank you.
Thank you. South Africa, yeah. Wow, folks, those were some strong answers to some really tough questions from five outstanding women. The selection committee has a big decision to make. Which finalist will move one step closer to the title? We'll find out after this break.